This is Missy Lynx, and you're listening to the Indy Sports Car Podcast.
Welcome, ICP fans, to another episode of Lowdown for the Showdown, presented by Missy Lynx. What's up, Missy?
Hello, hello. And joining us again tonight is Christian. Welcome back, Christian.
Thank you for having me. Happy to be here.
What's going on, Christian? How are you, sir?
I'm well, thank you. Just moved into a beautiful new apartment here in Indianapolis, Indiana. Two blocks away from my old apartment, but still very close to the track. I'm feeling good.
Now, was your first apartment higher or lower than the last? Like, was in like a couple story building, or how are apartments like in Indianapolis?
Well, it depends, man. Most people have like just one story houses, and that's what I was in my old place. But now I'm in a complex, and I'm on the third floor, the highest floor, and it's not bad. My cat likes it.
How's the legs feel? That's a lot of stairs.
It is, but it's okay though, man. So the gym's really nice as well in here. So days when I can't make it over to Pit Fit, I can just go ahead and bang out a quick workout here.
Right on. Yeah. Has anybody ever measured your bicep?
I did a article for Max Sports and Fitness magazine a couple of years back, and for that they actually did. And that was for the magazine. I got like huge for the magazine, and I was doing about 20 inches.
Nice steroids, huh? Dude, human growth hormone.
No.
Awesome. I heard a funny story about measuring biceps. You want to hear it?
No.
Sure.
No. Yeah. No. You do. remember Predator? You know the greatest movie of all time.
Yes.
Okay. So, Jesse the Body Ventura, right? The worst impression of him ever. He had this complex about Arnold because he was always saying how much bigger he is than Arnold Schwarzenegger, right? So Arnold Schwarzenegger made the costume people go in there with a fake cloth ruler, right? And, you know, roll it around his bicep. And, because for some reason he was that, you know, narcissistic that he had to measure it every day. And I guess for some reason he asked them to measure Arnold's. So they did, and when they come back, they told him that Jesse the Body Ventura's bicep was 2 inches bigger. He went around for like a week, you know, bragging about that. And it was like a nationally like aired interview of Arnold, and Arnold was laughing about it. Right? He's like, "Yeah, I, I had him all change the tape measures so he thought he was bigger than mine, but I was actually 4 inches bigger than
Wow.
him. And when he heard that Jesse the Body, he was like really upset. So to smooth things over, Arnie, he sent over a box of the finest Cubans and some wine. And said, gotcha or something.
Okay.
I wish I had the money to blow just to do that.
I don't ever want to get that big again, though, to be honest. I had like an F-1600 race about a week and a half after we shot that, and I just didn't fit in the car anymore. It was weird.
You were
No,
just.
really, like, my shoulders were too wide, and I didn't have any flex in my arms to be able to steer properly. It was bad.
That's all they are, is like a walking mummy, really.
All right, I'm gonna stop this conversation right now. Watkins Glen this weekend, IndyCar Grand Prix at the Glen.
On Christian.
Yes, that is this weekend. So your hashtag for it is IndyCar GP, and our course here is a 3.37 mile road course. You have six right corners and four left corners. In 2009, your winner Justin Wilson was the first IndyCar race winner ever for Dale Coyne Racing after 25 years of competition.
Yay.
This track is long known as the home of the Formula One United States Grand Prix, hosted for 20 consecutive years from 1961 to 1980. 1956, a permanent circuit was built. The circuit is known as the Mecca of North American road racing. And your surface for IndyCar, anyway, is made of asphalt and concrete because there's different configurations for different series. And in 2016, you had three cautions for nine laps. Your winner was Scott Dixon, followed by Joseph Newgarden, Elio Castroneves, Connor Daly, Sebastian Bourdais, Charlie Kimball, Simon Pagenaud, Alexander Rossi, RC Enerson, Max Chilton was your top 10. And your average lap speed last year was 119.334. And this week, your expensive picks. You have Joseph Newgarden has one start here and one top three. Scott Dixon has seven starts here, six top tens, five top threes, and four wins here. Elio Castroneves has seven starts, four top tens, two top fives, and one top three. Simon Pagenaud has one start and one top ten. Will Power has three starts and one win. Your cheapy picks this weekend. You have Connor Daly has one start here and one top ten. Ed Jones doesn't have any IndyCar starts. He does have an Indy Lights start last year where he finished second in the race. Charlie Kimball has one start with one top ten. Max Chilton has one start and one top ten. Spencer Piggott, one start, zero top tens. J.R. Hildebrand has no IndyCar starts here. He does have an Indy Lights start here in 2009 where he finished first. And then Jack Harvey, who was racing this weekend for Schmidt-Peterson Motorsports in the number seven, has right, is that right? Yeah. Has zero starts here. And your notables for this weekend, you have Graham Rahal has three starts, one top 10. Alexander Rossi has one start and one top 10. Ryan Hunter-Reay has four starts, two top 10s, and one win here. And Sebastian Bourdais has one start and one top five here.
All right. And I'd say the biggest part of this whole track, the most challenging, is the boot where you push 5 Gs. Do that 90 times over, right? 90 laps, right, Missy?
Is it 90 laps this weekend?
It was last year.
Oh, last year I thought I had it written down something different. Sorry, flipping through my paper notes.
If anybody hasn't figured it out, that sound is a notebook.
60 laps last year. Hawkins Glen was 60 laps last year.
Hey, Christian, that's a lot of G's, doing it 60 times, huh?
Oh, absolutely. Those who say we're not athletes really don't know what they're thinking about. That's brutal.
Exactly, man. I mean, that's what they were saying about Sato. That's why he crashed towards the end of it, because he just had nothing left in his arms. He was all jelly.
Yeah, I could see that, man.
He was a big fire stewed jelly. he's just jiggling down the front stretch.
No, this race will put you through the ringer for sure.
It surely will, and I love the first turn here where the chicane doesn't matter. I love that. The outside chicane, they just pop right over.
Yeah.
Pop right down. I love it. All right. Well, as Missy was going through that, I picked my picks. That's right. But speaking of picks, Missy, before that, hold on, let me just hit save here this time. Good God, that was
yes.
very.
Be sure to do that.
That was extremely embarrassing. Ugh. Anyway, okay, let me hit save here. And save picks. There we are. And now hit back. Yeah, certainly. Okay, there we go. All right. So, what people are going for this week is as follows. Joseph Newgarden. Not shocked there. At 33. Scott Dixon at 31. Elio Castroneves at 30. With Will Power at... That's a 28. Yep. Need glasses. then we got Graham Rahal at 26. Bourdais. Look at Bourdais popping up to 25 already. 1 week back. Or 2 weeks back, I guess. But after 1 week, anyway. But Bourdais and Rossi, along with Hinchcliffe at 25. Ryan Hunter-Reay is Tony Kanaan at 24. Sato is, it's the lowest all year, 23. And then here we are again with the big downward slide into the teens from the 20s. We go from 23 to 18 with the Munoz and Andretti. Sharing that one. $17. It looks like it is. Connor Daly, Ed Jones, Chuck Kimball, and Max Chilton. All four of them. Only $17. Ed Jones does not belong in that group. And then your bottom of the barrels, you got Spencer Pigot, J.R. Hildebrand, and Jack Abbey. Carlin Spotter when he's not racing IndyCar. So, and that's how much everybody costs. K Dubs. That's you, Christian.
Is that my new name now?
Well,
okay, didn't realize I had been.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. By the way, there's a new nickname for you. It's K Dubs.
Okay. I'll take it.
Well, your name begins with a K. And how do you spell that name, Christian? So people can go on Facebook and find your awesome book.
K R I S T I A N, last name A L E I X O.
Right on. And Missy, when it finally goes on, it's right now it is ready for its second run. And when it does go for that second run, Missy, where will they be able to find all the good retweets at from us?
On our Twitter, at ISCP Podcast.
Way to.
That was a terrible lead in, by the way. If you're trying to go for www.theindysportscarpodcast.com.
I was okay. I'll try again in 20 minutes. So, hey, Christian, who's picking who and
Okay, popular picks for this list.
why?
Scott Dixon on top, 136%.
Scott Dix. It's a good thing he's not Scott
Will
Dix off.
Power. Yeah. Will Power at 106.3%. Joseph Newgarden, 89.5%. Graham Rahal, Mr. Steak and Shake, 74%. Connor Daly,
Please don't you ever do.
66.8%.
Don't ever do that again.
Whatever, do what again?
You just put the whole image of that ridiculous fire suit in my head of a ridiculous man. So listen,
Don't hate on the bow tie. Don't
I
hate
don't hate
on the
on
bow tie
Graham's
and the
talent,
apron.
but Graham Rahal fans, I message to Graham Rahal fans. Everyone laughs at you at the track when you walk around with that stupid shirt on. I'm sorry. And hey, I don't care. I want you to like a driver, but I mean there's like I mean I go into the tent all the time. There's plenty of other choices to there to be had by Graham Rahal and the merchandise man. All right. Stop buying the Steak and Shake shirt, please. Moving on. Sorry about that, Christian.
No worries. Connor Daly, 66.8%. Alexander Rossi, 57.5%. RHR at 56.8%. JR Hildebrand, 46.3%. Ed Jones from Dubai, 44.5%. Simon Pagenaud, 44.3%. Sebastian Bourdais, 44% flat. Spencer Piggott, 39.8%. Marco Andretti at 32.3%. The mayor of Hinchtown, 29.8. Helio Castroneves, 26.5%. Carlos Munoz, 23.5%. Takuma Sato at 20.3%. Tony Kanaan, 19.8%. Why can't he learn? Max Chilton, 17.8%. Charlie Kimball, 17.5%. And my main man, Jack Harvey, really proud of him. We've done the celebrity cook-off here in Indianapolis the last 2 years together.
What did you
We
cook?
typically we cook at Benihana, so it's all like Japanese steak and shrimp.
Oh, you do you get to shoot like shrimp in people's mouth?
We do. We definitely do. And Jack and I are usually the only drivers that come out. So really proud of him for getting a ride. 7.3% for Jack.
So, like, what's your batting average with the shrimp?
Oh man, I'm like 9 times out of 10, to be honest. I've got amazing accuracy
That's
when
awesome.
it comes to flipping shrimp off of the yeah. People,
I
they pick
get,
me when they want to catch one in their mouth.
yeah, I would be sending people to the hospital with poked out eyes and shrimp stuck in no nostrils, definitely. That's what I'd do. How about you, Missy? Do you think you'd be a good shrimp flinger at Benihana's?
Sure.
Okay, cool. So Missy, you sound really excited about this. Who's picking who in lineup? So, do you have any problems with prices or who's picking who?
Prices. I mean, I'm glad that Sebastian jumped. I mean, a 10th place finish, he jumps up $25. You could have just stuck him $25 last week. You knew he was going to be there. Why'd you put him at 15? Really?
Hey, you called it.
Just throwing it out there. I don't know. And probably, I guess I'm okay with prices.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess I'm okay.
What
I don't
about
have that
who's
many
picking who?
complaints. Well, I'm not surprised Scott Dixon's at the top. He's won 4 times. I doubt he's going to have a fifth time this year, but
Hey,
never
there's,
know.
I mean, a girl can dream.
I don't know why Connor Daly's being picked so high. Maybe it's because he's $17, but
He finally
I
gets a
mean,
top five. He Connor, say what you will about Connor, he does have the heartbeat of the fans, doesn't he?
Yeah, I guess he did
He
finish
gets a
fourth here
top
last
five,
year,
and
but
people are probably mad that he's not. I mean, he's only what, 17 bucks. People are probably mad that he's not 27.
whoa, that's overambitious if they think he's going to be 27, but
Well, I'm just saying, he's just really got a huge fan base. I'm just saying.
let's see.
But who doesn't love Quagmire, really?
Yeah, I guess I'm okay with the
Quagmire?
percentages, really.
Look at him. He looks just
What?
like Quagmire. Don't
Oh,
he? He drives
wow,
around Watkins Glen. Giggity,
wow.
Well, it's a lot better than what Damian Power said about him. And
This is
he
clean.
didn't say it behind his back either. He said it to his face. Can't believe me. You don't say that to somebody. You talk about, you say that behind their back. Anyway,
I didn't even say.
you could dig a ditch with his chin.
Jeez.
And he completed one quarter of a pace lap that year when he was interviewed. Yep. Anyway, go ahead, Missy. I'm sorry.
I'm done. I'm fine with it.
You're fine with everything?
Yeah, sure. No guy in complaints.
Not that Ed Jones is picked like. Actually, I think
He's
it.
picked a decent
I
amount.
yeah, I was gonna say he's being picked up where he should, I think. And he's finally gaining some love with the money. I like to see that. Christian, how about you, buddy?
It's another tough week. I feel like these last three, four races have been just really tough with that steep drop in between the last of the 20s and the beginning of the teens.
Yeah,
But
Missy, when did they start doing that?
that's only been like I agree with Christian, like the last 3, 4 weeks they've been doing it.
Yes,
And I don't know why. I don't know if they're doing it on purpose, make it more challenging. What's the
That,
what that's
well,
about?
that would be the purpose, I would say.
It does make it a little more difficult, but
It definitely does. It definitely does. I mean, I'm still gonna pull out a top five, whatever, but
not last
it's
week you
tough.
didn't.
I know. I
Yeah.
know.
Congratulations, Billy Lehman.
Know. Did Billy win last week?
Yes, he did.
Oh, he didn't. Get out, really?
Yep, he did.
Wow.
He drives the ISCP podcast Legends car. That's right.
Well, congratulations, Billy. Good, good, good deal.
So, Christian,
Yes, sir.
got any problems with anybody on there? Who's
Oh, I'm
picking
sorry. I didn't answer that question. No. We're no.
who?
I'm my bad. My bad. No. I'm okay. I think I'm all right with everybody.
Yeah, good all around. All right, yeah, okay. Let me tear it apart then. I'm always the bad guy. Why not? Every
Simon
good.
Cowell of the show.
Every good show needs a heel, I suppose. And who better than the one that loves wearing them? So, I mean,
Wait.
basically,
Certainly ain't me.
one, two. Well, you sure do have enough of them. You should try to wear them, and I don't know, make my money mean something. So anyway, that the top five I'm really good with. The top number six, giving them too much love. Bourdais loving it at number 25. Rossi's too high. Hinch is about right. RHR is about right. TK is too high. Tyler's too low. Munoz, yes. Marco, way too high, about three too high. Connor's right where he belongs. Ed's too low. Chuck Kimball shouldn't be on this grid. Max Chilton, well, he's learning to go from 15 to 17 at least. Piggott,
Why can't I learn?
why can't I
What?
learn to be 18? Why can't I learn to stay in the 20s? Or no, he's never been in the 20s. And then Spencer Piggott, J.R.'s mullet, and Jack Harvey, 15, where they should be. Every rookie for his first race should be 15, no matter what. Unless you're Alonso, then put him at 31. So anyway, and that's my assessment of the prices and how much they suck. So, moving on to who's picking who, the beautiful, beautiful IndyCar fans out there that supported Gateway and came out to Gateway and made it an awesome short oval, a just awesome race. And the crowd was there, the racing was there. How, I hope the TV ratings were there. I have no idea. I gotta check into that. Anyway, I would say the top three, from 136 to 89% of the people picking, they're dead on. And the rest of them, they're just grasping at straws, right? Or flies, whatever that term is, that's what they're doing. So there you go.
Alrighty
That's my assessment of this week. Who'd you pick, Christian?
then. My picks this week, Scott Dixon, Joseph Newgarden, unbiased, J.R. Hildebrand,
what?
and Ed Jones.
Hildebrand.
Well,
Hildebrand.
if all he went with the two high-priced ones, he had to pick cheapies.
I did. That's right.
That is
Couldn't make it
true.
work any other way. I tried.
Right? See? You get me. You get me.
I got you. I see where you're going.
I'm picking up what you're putting down. Nice.
Hopefully, Newgarden and Dixon can carry it, and maybe get a solid finish out of Hildebrand and Jones somewhere in the top 10.
Probably not. I mean, there's way too
I don't
many.
need your negativity.
There are way too many cars out there for J.R. Hildebrand to drive over top of, okay? So.
Was Ed Carpenter.
Well, no, Ed learned from J.R. doing it so many times. Missy, who'd you pick?
I picked. Where's my lineup?
It's on
There we go.
IndyCar.com/fantasy or
Yeah, I know. I didn't have it pulled up.
whatever.
So I decided to go with Ed Jones, Alexander Rossi, Joseph Newgarden, and Ryan Hunter-Reay. And my average lap speed, I went with 120.120.
That's very generous. All right. By the way, Christian, what was your lap speed again? I'm sorry.
I went with 120.009.
Wow, aren't you just
Oh.
dead on? So now I've confirmed that you two talk behind my back. All right. I knew it. I knew it. I knew it. There was eventually going to be one to take her away from me, and at least I like them. So, my lineup, okay. By the way, good lineup, Missy. I have nothing against it. All right, so my lineup.
Oh, how shocking.
I know. My lineup's close to nobody's. Sebastian Bourdais, Joseph Newgarden. Well, everybody should have him, by the way. 186,000% of you do, or whatever. Then Alexander Rossi and Jack Aave. Actually, that's really close.
Oh, okay.
That's really close to Kirk Christians, I think.
No.
Yep. You bastard. Never mind.
Wait, you have Joseph Newgarden and Alexander Rossi on your lineup?
And Jack Aivik.
Yeah, no, I heard you. No, because I have Joseph and Alexander too.
But I got Seabass because he's going to have that, you know, that just extra moxie, as Christian likes to say.
It's a great word.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, you just don't get to say it enough in a sentence.
I don't. You don't, really. That's one of my favorites.
It's kind of like gargantuan in Kill Bill.
That's another good word. Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah.
I'm excited for this.
You often rarely get to use it in a sentence. Missy, go. Word that you hardly ever use.
I don't know.
No, you say that a lot.
Put her on the spot, see?
I mean, the words I use on a daily basis are, you know, probably not for this podcast.
And you've probably heard most of them that are. So, and it was a 110.011. All right. What do you think about my lineup? Anybody? You know, I know it's awesome. Right.
That's all right.
All right, let's move on. To the next, what's the next thing we do?
Schedule. And then wrap it up.
Well, yeah, I think, yeah. I don't know. I feel like we're forgetting something. But this is pretty.
Well, sometimes we read last week's results.
That's what it was. Others don't. Well, I mean, Billy Lehman won. Everybody else kind of tied each other all the way up to like 15th, and then I didn't do good. You did sort of mediocre. Missy did. About...
Missy beat both your butts last week.
Yeah.
Enjoy it while you got it.
Basically, it's
last week.
What's the hashtag for this race again?
IndyCar GP.
Nice, easy. Hashtag IndyCar GP. Just want to throw it out there, guys. The Sonoma race. For those of you that have been playing all year, sorry, Christian. Sorry, Mike. But maybe next year. We have, should we do the yellow and black hat this time, Missy? For the Sonoma, well, not the Sonoma winner, but the overall winner of all, you know, how many events there's there? Like 16?
Yeah, all 16, yeah.
Or 17? It's 17.
17.
Yeah, all 17 events, you know, who have been with IACP rivals, whoever wins the you know, number one out of all, who's played all 17 events, they get to, they win a Matt Bell and Ryan Liddell signed Continental hat that we got them to sign for us for the winner of Indy Rivals. And I know that really ties in well because they race in Continental Sports Car Championship, and this is a prize for the Indy Rivals. And you know what? It wouldn't be ICP if it was any other way, right, Christian?
That's right.
I mean, I had a Tristan Volte visor, but it went somewhere else. And that would have made more sense, even though he still doesn't really race IndyCar. At least he did a really great job at Texas. Anyway.
Yeah, he did.
But hey, I mean, Matt Bell and Ryan Liddell, come on, still good. It's not like I got, you know, people have never heard of to sign a hat, right? Okay, moving on. You ever hear of them too? Christian? Right?
No.
Seriously? Yes, you did, you liar. Okay, so are there any notables on what was it, event 15, I guess?
Wait, what?
Or are we on 15?
No, we're on 16.
It's I thought.
Yeah.
That's right. Okay. All right.
Second to last race of the season.
Oh boy. Okay, so some big news came out today about
It's okay.
Andretti. What?
Football's picking it up.
What's that?
It's okay. Football is right around the corner.
Yep, we did our
That'll
fantasy draft.
keep us going till, yeah, that'll keep us going till racing comes back, right?
Red Zone channel. I mean, are you a Red Zone channel from 1 to 7 kind of guy?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I'm almost not an Eagles fan anymore because of that. Yeah, I do not watch the Eagles and then put on Red Zone. If the Eagles score, I'll see it on Red Zone. If they don't, I've seen so much of them sucking. I don't need to see any more of it in my life. I swear. But I get really excited when it's an Eagle, though. I'll give it that.
I hear you.
Does that make me a bad fan?
Yes.
I figured.
Short answer, yes.
Well, you know what? The Missy's right with me, though, aren't you?
What?
Okay.
Don't drag me down.
Yeah. While you do it with me. Okay, so if anybody's going to be at the Watkins Glen race this week, we'll be there. So just shoot us a DM and say hello. So I really think there's something else we're missing here, but I don't know what it is. Do you? Oh yeah. The big news that's happened since our recording on Monday with Molly and DeHarty and of course Christian. Till now, Alexander Rossi and Andretti Autosport Racing or whatever, AA, if you want to call it that. I thought the Twitter domino thing was weird. It's not like it landed on a Honda or anything. It just said Honda at the end next to, the Andretti logo. So Andretti's staying with Honda. That's interesting, being though Sato's already gone, pretty much. So he says he's gonna be. And then throughout, let me see, am I, do I have this right so far?
So far.
Do you want to take over the solder part?
Wants him to take over. Apparently he's going to Ray Hall Letterman Lanigan.
Yeah, but is it apparent or is it a definite now since staying with Honda?
I mean, as far as we know, he's going to
As far as Robin Miller goes,
Yeah, I mean, it's all I got to go off of, so that's what it is at the moment.
what he said about Bourdais before Watkins Glen this year happened. And if there's any team that needs another car, it'd be Sato. I mean, it'd be, Lanigan or Ray Hall, whatever. Ray Hall. So, in
And you
comes
also
out
have,
Rossi. I mean,
Rossi.
Yeah, Rossi's staying. That's actually definite. That just came over Twitter.
Yes, he signed another 2 years.
I'm surprised. Christian?
Why are you surprised?
Because what else has he done but win the 500 last year on a fuel strategy race? I know it's a win. I'm not taking it away.
Okay. I was about to say, man. I mean,
Not for nothing, he earned that win because I've never seen anybody get fuel mileage out of a car like that. Yeah,
right. That was
he hit numbers never even dreamed of. So, Anyways,
Well, his strategist. I mean that's more on him, to be honest, than
actually, who won Rossi? Yeah, if we want to get down to the nitty gritty of it, his doofus fueler that for three times in a row could not get the freaking thing into the car, and every pit stop was like 12 plus seconds. That's what won him that race, because that's what made him, I don't know how it somehow put him on a weird fuel strategy that won him that race.
but he got it.
But of course they said it turned out to be a faulty batch of fuel insert nozzle thingies on a hose majummer. So anyways, that's the official word for it too. Yeah, I don't think a 2-year signing warrants what he's accomplished so far. Missy, do you think so?
Why not? I mean, Marco's still there.
You know what? Great counter argument. no matter what Andretti does, I mean, Marco's still there, so how can you really question it? good point. And
Is a good point.
you know what? Not for nothing. And there's no other news that's come out. And if there is, we will let you know on tomorrow while we are at Watkins Glen schmoozing and walking around and eating and schmoozing, whatever, just being us the way we do it. And if any new news comes out, we'll, pay attention to the channel. And where can they find all that good stuff, Missy?
Oh, that would be www.theindiesportscarpodcast.com.
That's right. And even though I suck at live streaming through Facebook, I still like doing it for some reason. So, and by the way, if I don't say hi to your name, it's because Facebook sucks. And I think nobody's watching. Then I end it, and I have like 400 and some views. And I'm like, I guess there are a bunch of people on there. Oops. So, Facebook, fix your live stream number thing. That'd be great. And I think on that note.
Oh no. So the schedule for this weekend before we wrap up. Everything kicks off tomorrow, starting bright and early at 8 a.m. with USF 2000 Practice One. Then you have Pro Mazda Practice One will happen at 9:30, and that will be the first thing that is streaming on IndyCar.com, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. And then you have the Verizon IndyCar Series Practice 1 starting at 10:15 a.m. And this is all Eastern Standard Time since it's New York. Then you have USF 2000 Practice 2 happening at 1 p.m. Then Pro Mazda qualification for Race 1 will happen at 2:30 p.m. IndyCar Series Practice 2 will happen at 3:05. Then they're going to have a pit stop practice at 3:55 p.m. Then you have Indy Lights Practice 1 will happen at 4:25 p.m. And all that will be streaming on IndyCar.com, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, except for the USF 2000 Practice 1. Apparently won't be streaming on anything. So, and then on Saturday, you have USF 2000 qualifications, which apparently will not be streaming on anything, starting at 8 a.m. And then you will have Indy Lights Practice 2. Everything starting here will be on IndyCar.com, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, starting at 8:45 a.m. Practice 3 for IndyCar will happen at 10:30 a.m. Pro Mazda Race 1 will happen at 11:30 a.m. USF 2000 will happen at 1:15 p.m. Their race, their only race 1. I guess you will. And then Indy Lights qualification will happen at 2:15 p.m. Verizon IndyCar Series qualification will happen at 3 p.m. And then I don't know if that's. I think that's streaming. Verizon IndyCar Series is streaming at 3 p.m. Then you have Pro Mazda qualification for race 2 will happen at 5:30, and apparently that's not streaming on anything. And then they have the Verizon IndyCar Series qualifications re-air, which I don't see where it was going to air originally, just streaming on NBC Sports Network at 7 p.m. So I guess if you don't want to know what happened until 7 p.m., you better go social media dark. And then on Saturday or Sunday, you have Pro Mazda Race 2 will happen at 7:55 a.m. And it will be streaming IndyCar.com, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. IndyCar Series Final Warm-Up will happen at 9 a.m. Indy Lights Race will happen at 10:50 a.m. And then the broadcast window for the IndyCar Grand Prix at the Glen will start at 1 p.m. on NBC Sports Network. And that's all Eastern Standard Time. I remember there's only one race for Indy Lights, one race for USF 2000, and two races for Pro Mazda this weekend.
Yep.
And this is their championship. So everything comes down to this weekend.
Only 2 points apart.
Dun, dun, dun,
all Oliver has to do is land, and he'll win. Kidding. But, Indy Lights is going to be interesting. It always is at the end, isn't it? Last race of the season. Anyways. Hey, Jones, you know, one year. I guess Piggott wasn't that big of a shock. All right. Right on. So, Missy. Christian, any new news out of any of the other 17 other ventures you got going on?
We're just focusing on the book right now. Really, really close to securing our deal for next year. So at least I'll know who I will be running with for next season. So that's always a good thing to get out the way. And a couple of other things too, but I can't really mention
what.
No, a couple other things too on my plate. I've always got something right, but I can't mention it just yet. So
how about give us one little tidbit you're working on?
Working on bringing a race car manufacturer here to America.
Interesting. And on that note, yeah. Missy.
Looking to be integral part.
What's that?
No, just looking to be an integral part of bringing this this foreign manufacturer to America for the first time.
That's interesting, and I'd like to hear more about it. And we know you're going to be on the show again really soon, and we're going to pick it up because I'm not going to ask you. I'm just going to contemplate, and then the next show you're on, I'm going to guess and see if I'm right. How about that?
Okay.
And Missy, okay, on that note.
And on that note, you know that I know that Frank, yeah, he doesn't know. Christian, yeah, he knows a little bit. And it's Watkins Glen this weekend, you know?
Beep, beep.